Cecille's blessing!
Ah!
blessing!
Take that spear! Hold your
For a moment, I found myself in my fury considering Antoinette's suggestion. And though it was not her intention, it was that moment that brought me clarity. No one would rebel without cause. If rebellion were a power play by an ambitious commander, it would likely only come when the commander felt safe in their superiority as a fighting force. Though the Illidrian soldiers were some of the best, Mercer was not such a fool as to think they would have bested the multiple legions I marched to meet him. The soldiers had only followed him because they shared his concerns, however ultimately unfounded they may have been. If I were to simply execute them en masse, or even in great numbers, I would be more likely to foment further rebellion, not crush it out. After all, as David had once said, the comfortable may be intimidated by fear. The desperate are only convinced. would be the last speech of its kind that I gave. I'd hoped the rebellion and its resolution would put to rest similar talk, though why I held that foolish misapprehension, I cannot say. Perhaps I was simply blinded by the perceived power of my new title. But whatever the reason, it was quickly becoming clear that control over my army was rapidly deteriorating.
Defense!
done what any commander ought and send advanced scouts to corroborate my brother's story. Unfortunately, my first concern was haste. And as Bowendale said to David on many occasions, haste is brother to need, sister to concern, and mother to failure.
Let's go! Odie's blessing!
We'll be right back.
blessing!
Scorch!
Fear makes guilt of innocence. Morton's agents had infiltrated David's court and launched a barrage of assassination attempts and other acts of covert terror that had put the Great King on edge. Unsure of who to trust, he had asked Bowendale, his court's wise woman, for her advice. The only words she had for him were Owen Wolen in Sun Yid. The fear of unjust prosecution can make a loyal subject turn treasonous. Fear of one's subjects can make a ruler guilty of the very cruelties those who would destroy that ruler accused them of. Antoinette's borrowing his soul had spoken to mine, and, as only she could do, calmed it. Senna had been more right than she knew when she said I was not the only one in the army with raw nerves. My ill-considered command to strip the town bare had filtered out into the rank and file without its subsequent retraction. And by the time I had learned what had happened, it was too late. They had turned into a rampaging force of nature which could not be controlled. I tried not to think on the horrors that were committed that night in my name. But I could not keep them from my mind. There they sat, staring down at me with blood-soaked, eyeless faces full of hate. It was not long before I saw them everywhere.